In this particular video, we are going to be taking a look at creating a port scanner, a very basic port scanner. And I'm going to be using Gitpod, which is a fantastic IDE that you can sort of use on GitHub. So again, it's a one-click online IDE for GitHub, and I already have my instance set up here. So I can essentially work on multiple files and they get saved directly onto my GitHub here. And the link to this GitHub repository where I'll be storing all of these pen testing tools will be in the description section, so you can check it out for yourself. So just a few other bits of information. Our target website today will be hackthissite.org, and we'll be using the IP address to actually perform our scans. So let's get started. So I already have mine set up in my workspace on Gitpod here, and I'll create a new file and I'll call it, we'll just call it port scanner. And we'll be working with sockets. So if you haven't learned about sockets in Python 3, you can definitely watch our previous videos on that. And you can see immediately we're able to get started here. So we'll just close this up and we will set up our environment user bin and Python 3, and we can actually get started now. All right, so I'll hit save here and we can actually get started. So our main objective is to create a port scanner that scans an IP and a particular port and checks to see if it's open, right? So now that we're interacting with sockets, or we want to actually utilize networking in Python 3, we need to import the socket library. So I'm going to say import socket. We don't need everything, so we can just import this. We can just say import socket. And then we need to start creating. We're going to say S is going to be, that's our variable. So we're then going to call upon the module we want to use. So socket dot socket, and this is the class itself. So the socket class, and then we start saying the methods here. So socket, we're going to call upon the AF inet, which is specifying that I'm working with IPv4, and then we're going to say socket, and we're specifying the connection type now, which I've already explained before. So socket, also soc iStream or stream, sorry, and we're going to say stream here. And you can essentially just highlight here. So we have the module socket, the class here. And then, of course, we call upon AFINET, which we're essentially using to specify the type of connection, which is IPv4, the protocol. And then SockStream specifies the type of connection. So if it's SockStream, it means it's TCP. That means there is a handshake going on. If you want UDP, you can also specify that as well. Again, you can refer back to our socket video where we explain all of this. So let us first set up a host that we can actually use to scan. So I'm going to say host is going to be equal to, and we'll just say host is going to be equal to, and we're going to get the IP for, we can just say ping hack this site.org, and I'm going to hit enter, and we just get the IP here. And of course, I'm guessing we'll have a SSL or HTTPS port open. So I'm going to say port is going to be equal to, we'll just say port 443, for example, which I know is going to be open, and we're going to be using this to test it. You can also test this script locally, which I'll also do just to show you that it does work. So now that we have all our basic components here, we can create a function. And this function, the responsibility of this function is to, of course, perform the actual scanning. So we're going to say def. Port scanner, that's going to be the name of this particular function, and the variable we're going to be passing, or the value here, is going to be the value of port. And we're going to say if, we're going to use an if statement just to actually perform our scan. So we can say if s dot connect, which is socket dot connect. We can say if it returns an error code. So again, if we use connect x underscore ex and we just hover over it, you can see this is like connect address. However, it returns an error code, which means it will essentially terminate, and we can get our results. And this will tell us if the port is closed, right? So instead of giving us an exception or raising an exception and then performing something else, we can just say if this is the case. And then we have to pass in the values here. So we're going to say host and port. We then say print the following. So we're going to say print, say the port is closed, right? Very, very simple. And then we say else. This is, of course, if it does not give us an error code, That means the port is open. So we're going to say print. So we can say the port is open. The port is open, right? So we can hit save. And now we actually need to call upon this function. I'm not going to create a main function just because I want to keep it really simple. So we can say port scanner. And I'm going to, again, pass the variable port there. So I'm going to hit save. We're going to call that function and we can right click. And this is the great thing about Gitpod, is we can actually execute our code here. And immediately we are told that the port is open. So let's see if they have an SSH port running here. I'm going to hit save. And of course, we're just going to run this in the terminal one more time. It tells us that the port is closed. Let's see if they have port 80 open. And we'll run this one more time. And the port is open as well. So really, really cool stuff here. Let's see if they have FTP open. And we'll just run this one more time. Let's see. Let's see if we can actually run this. For some reason, did I save the script? Let me just terminate this one more time here. Run that file in the terminal. And we'll wait for this to scan. So you can see that it takes quite a while for some scans. And we can improve the speed of this script by essentially setting a default timeout. And we get that functionality with the socket library or the socket module. So what we can do is, let me just terminate this one more time. And what I'll do is I'll download this script onto my computer here. And I'll just save it. So I'll say save here. And that's in my downloads folder. So let me just open up a new terminal here. So we'll go to CD, downloads, and hit enter. So chmod plus X, and we'll say port scanner, right? So now if I execute it, so I can say Python 3 port scanner and hit enter. It's going to, of course, we need to specify, we need to change the code a little bit here. So before we do that, let me just clear this out. Nano, and we will say port scanner. And let's change this to maybe my router IP address. And let's check if we have the SSH port open. 168.1.1. And we'll change this to port 22. Hit enter. And we'll again repeat the same thing. And the port is open, which is excellent. And now let us try and let's try another port here. Let's say FTP. So we can hit Control O, X, and get out of here. Run this one more time. For some reason, there we are, the port is closed. So with scanning web servers, it's going to take a bit of time, but I'll show you how to improve the speed shortly. So there are a few issues with this particular script. One of them is that we need to keep on going into the script to specify the IP and the port. So we should definitely implement some user input here just to make it a whole lot better. So what I'll do is I'll remove this script now and we'll download it once we've made changes to the new one. So the logic is perfectly fine here. However, we do need to change a few things in regards to the host and the port variable. And we need to get some user input, right? So what we'll do for the host variable in Python 3, we need to specify the input. So that is denoted by input. And for the host, we can take it as a string. So we can say, we then prompt the user to enter enter value. So we can say, please enter, we can say, please enter the IP you want to scan, right? And they're gonna enter that. And for the port, we need to make sure that this is in the form of an integer, because that's the most important. We're gonna be passing it through this particular function here. So to do that, we say int, and we're going to say input within this brackets here. And then again, we just give the user some text. So we say, please enter the port you want to scan. So let's just get rid of that, port you want to scan, and we'll hit enter just to save it like so. And now we can actually make it the script a lot faster by, you know, setting the default timeout period. So again, this will be the period in which it will perform a scan. And if it does not get a response, it will return the value. In this case, again, once we are passing it, once we actually perform, we take it through the port scanner function. Again, we can set whatever value we want. And of course, this might not be the best thing to do, because some ports may take a longer time to actually give us a response. So what we need to do is we can say set default, we can say set default timeout, we can set the timeout here, And we'll set the timeout to maybe, let's say, 5 seconds, right? So we can set the default timeout to 5 seconds here and hit save. All right, and now since we'll be prompted with the actual input for this particular user, so we can go back in here and let me just copy this IP one more time, and we will run this script again. So we'll say now you can see it tells us right over here. Let me just increase the font size. You can see that the please enter the IP we want to scan, and we can simply paste in the IP here. So we can say paste, and we hit enter. And the port we want to scan is port 443. Hit enter, and so the port's open. So again, we can try this one more time, and we'll just paste in the IP there, and we can try this for port 21. And since we have specified it to 5 seconds, now if it does, there we are, you can see after 5 seconds, this time we get the response even faster. Now you can set this as long as you want, and you can also set up some logic to actually get the user to input the default or the timeout options that they're interested in, but that would really defeat the purpose here. So again, we can download this script and run it on our local network just to see how that goes. Let's see if it does work at all. So let's go to our downloads here. Yeah, we can go into downloads, and again, let us just make sure we can just expand this a little bit here. And we'll clear this out like so, and chmod plus x, and we'll this is the port scanner, and we'll say Python 3, and we want to run port scanner here. All right, so the IP you want to scan, let us scan one of my Windows PCs, 104, see if we have SMB here, and the port is open, so we can try our router one more time. 68.1.1, hit enter, and we'll try the SSH port, and the port is open. Let's try the, 192.168.1.1, and we'll say, port 3306, hit enter. Again, we have the default timeout, and there we are, the port is closed.